You're just a casual gamer that streams, not a streamer.
What are you doing, drugs?
You know. And that's really it. Like, there's nothing wrong with just saying, hey, I like to casually stream because I find it fun and YouTube. And if something comes of it, great. Something comes of it. And then it's like, oh, I really want this to become. Like, some streamers are pulling in 20 to 60,000 a month.
Yeah.
You know, you see, like, people
A
like,
lot of
oh,
people.
Frost, thank you for the follow. See people like Summit getting $20,000 donations live on the air, and you know, and yes,
Wow.
people, no, and yes, people, when you give someone a donation, you have a day to cancel it. So sometimes people donate a lot just to cancel it later, just so they can get themselves on the show. You can see some, like, I think it's like Soda Poppin' back in the day, or yeah, I think it was Soda Poppin', got like $28,000 donated from one guy, and but the guy was just doing it to fuck with him. Like, he kept donating like $1,000 at a time, and Soda Poppin', I think it was Soda Poppin', I could be wrong, was like, oh my god, yay, woo! And then the next day, it's like, yeah, the guy canceled all the payments. You know, it's PayPal, people. You can cancel it within 24 hours before it clears. We get that, like, I was drunk online regret, you know. But yeah, we have our fan club. You basically hit the donate button down below. You pay a $5 donation, and you put monthly. And every month, you take this $5 out of your PayPal account and gives it to me. But for that $5, you get like Geek Ronin katanas, Dragons of the Black
Yeah.
Swords, you know, t-shirts, patches.
Yeah, once I start getting a job, I will be doing that. I want a katana.
Yeah, I'm actually gonna start donating because.
Well, you know, to everyone, it's donation is like never solicited, always appreciated. I might talk about promotions we're doing, like for every $1,000 donated, we're giving away a PlayStation 4 to one lucky viewer. You don't even have to be a donator. You just have to be watching and a follower. Somebody, you know, other people donate the money for every $1,000. So if we get, you know, 2,000, we give away two, three. For every $1,000 we get, we're just gonna give one away.
Yeah, but
With one PSN card for $60, I recommend you do it for PS Live 1 year subscription so you can play online, but you could buy a game if you want. You know what I mean? No one can win twice in a year on that contest. So if you win one, you're out of the drawing. And we just do like a random, you know, online. Everyone types in, you know, a word I choose on the day I choose, when I choose. And that's a great way to build viewers because they don't know what day or when I'm going to give it away.
Yeah.
True, right after the competition, you can expect about a third to a quarter of your followers watching you to stop watching you for the day, just like they do with Tally because the competition's over. But I've sat and watched Tally for 6 hours just to enter a competition to try to win something. It's not a ploy, it's just a smart way if you're going to give stuff away. Unless you're in my house, it's all sealed up drugs. Yeah, that's fine. I'm right across from you, by the way. Yeah, the door
So
with.
he's watching you. He's
Yeah.
watching you drugs.
So the door with the dirt covering it, that's mine. I already got stuff in there. That's cool. Yeah, Killer J had that one, but to be honest, like, I'm not too fussy if people pick a different shop. But it'd be nice if, you know, like, Exile wants his right here back. And and don't forget, some of these are the villagers' houses, so you may just want to build a new shop, like, over here in this little meadow. If we rob the villagers of their houses, they may leave. Too much. Feel free, people. Yeah, like, over here, these meadows and stuff, you can expand the city out quite a bit. All right, I just came down to look at that
We haven't
property.
really had too much of a crash today.
No, I'm telling you, it's really, I think it was that save was corrupted somehow. So,
Yeah, there was a little bit earlier, but it
well,
wasn't too
we've
bad.
never played Minecraft on the PS3 without got a sign.
Yeah.
No, I don't. Sorry.
Yeah, without something
Donation
messing up.
Yeah.
On my
I mean,
channel.
like you said on like an earlier date, it only uses like 4% of what the PS4 could be or the PS3 could
Yeah, it
be right
doesn't even
now.
take like 50% of its processing power. That's what's really weird.
Yeah, it's just blocks and
exactly
stuff. The graphics aren't even, it's not even taxing it for the graphics.
No. I don't know what it is, and I should do the research into why it's so shittily like given to the consoles, but it could be something that some big patches like in the works gonna fix, and you know, I mean, I should. I try to do a lot of research for my show, you know, on the games
I
I
mean,
play.
I know Dragon Age Inquisition will be taxing it quite a bit because it's not gonna be like where you travel and stuff. It's actually gonna be an open world and stuff like
Yeah.
Skyrim.
That's good.
That's what I'm actually interested for, and that's why they introduced the mounts into it.
Yeah, I would get that game if it wasn't going to be on the PS4. Like, I think it's one of those ones that I'd probably wait for the PS4.
Yeah, I don't have I'm not getting a PS4 anytime soon unless I get one given
to
me.
I wish I could. Yeah, no. I wish I could have one right now, but, you know, like I said, I do this to help support a family, and so it's like...
Yeah,
oh, look, I'm about to get my money for it. The kid broke a tooth. God damn it! But Christmas is coming up, too, so I'm also like, well, I just get it for Christmas? You know, maybe I should...
I don't know what your girlfriend's gonna get you.
No, I don't really even celebrate Christmas, so she usually doesn't get me anything.
Ah,
it's all good. I mean, you know, it'll come.
I mean,
when it
comes. I'm probably gonna have my mom get me Destiny for Christmas.
So every game I like to play that's on the PS3, like GTA and Destiny, you can just carry it over to the PS4. So I'm actually not even too worried about it. Pay $60 more, fine. Restart. Not have to. That's great.
My multiplayer later, stats and stuff will be. I know the multiplayer stuff will be carried over because it's.
Yeah. That's why I'm not worried about it at all. I'm just like.
I mean, I just want it so that way I have a game because I'm getting bored of all my other games.
Well,
and
Destiny's a big one here on the show, so I hate like. When we play Destiny, I hate leaving people out. But it's like I warned everyone too. It's going to be a huge one on the show.
Go.
Which I mean it, I people. We're going to be cutting down on, you know, some of the annoyance stuff. So if you're not really doing anything,
Drugs just came up to me and threw snowballs at me.
Yeah, it's probably kooky. It's like 3 a.m. for him. He's all getting all crazy.
Probably.
My goal of giveaways on my channel, I want to I reach my goal of getting my computer, a new PBR, a new PS4, and an Xbox One, I want to give away 2 of each.
Nice.
Yeah.
I mean, I'll take your. Is your PBR an external one?
I'm giving that one to my cousin.
Oh, darn.
Unless I give him an Elgato, which I haven't decided yet.
But, I mean, if you still have your old one when you get a new one and he already has one, I'll take your old one.
I'll just take it.
Because I can actually upload stuff to my YouTube. God damn it.
Now,
you could also stream, too.
Yeah, capture cards aren't that expensive, people. You're looking like $200 or less. I'm not saying it's cheap, but if you really think about like what you want to save up for or ask for and
stuff. You could get a really good Elgato for $180.
Oh, nice. Well, that requires me to actually have a job.
Well, no, I'm not saying you have the money, and I'm just speaking out to everyone on the show, YouTubes and Pass and Posts and all that. But if you guys really, you know, sit around, like I said, even if you just put $1 away a day, you know, eventually, you know, at the end of the month, you got half of the game.
I have $1 in my wallet.
Hey, I feel ya. I had $100 in my wallet the other day, and it was gone in like 2 hours at the grocery store, you know.
Oh, yeah. But
that's it. My mom spends like almost like... For when my brother was here, she was spending like almost $300 every couple weeks in groceries.
Yeah. Well, I mean, just that's why I have a big garden in the backyard too. You know.
You can get your vegetables and stuff.
Oh, quite a bit. I mean, tomatoes, kale, broccoli, spinach, lettuce, onions.
Pickles.
I haven't done cucumbers or zucchini. But do squash, melon, pumpkins, things like that. Right now, we actually just put in our winter lettuce. Harvested pretty much everything.
Nice. Don't forget to keep cowhide.
Oh, definitely. I love black leather jackets are so sick in this game.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But
yeah, that's
what you want them for books for an enchanting table.
I want Kratos would look. Kratos would look awesome in a black leather jacket.
Kratos wants jacket.
Kratos wants jacket. Kratos kill you for a jacket.
I don't
Kratos
know
if would if
anyone
really
else can
Kratos.
Sleep in a bed.
I can.
Oh, I have a bet. Let me grab.
Yeah, but we got Exile in here too, don't we? Still.
Yeah, we have several people.
Well, yeah, I don't think we're gonna be able to get everyone. I'm just saying, make your save spot. Yeah, it's a good reminder if you have one to do a save spot.
But. I'm putting the floor wood just because it'll look nice.
Oh yeah, I like to do like half wood planks on the floor. It does suck because you can't, you know, put stuff on them. It does a weird float thing, but I always like that look. I'll usually do like a raised floor, regular block with what I like, and then put steps in a sunken floor for like the lower. I really just try to, like, you know, build into nature when I play this game. A few times I've made some big cliff house or oceanside skyscrapers, and I'm going to do that a little bit with this one. But this house is going to be on the ocean floor in the long haul.
The computer that I'm going to build is going to cost $1,200.
Nice.
Wow.
I should send you the stuff to put the little Geekly Gaming Network on your stream.
I didn't realize I had my mic muted, so...
Oh, that's fine. Yeah, a lot of streamers I've noticed are joining streaming guilds, like Nexus and Pink and whatnot, Hammer Squad, you know. Kind of like a streaming guild where they all get together, they host each other and things like that. And we've got about 12 in ours.
Once I get good stuff to stream... Yeah. I will put.
Hey, Hacksaw's streamed on it. Hacksaw's officially been a Twitch streamer. He streamed on our Geekly Gaming Network. You know, some of us stream at the same time zone, but a lot of the people on my Geekly Gaming Network, they stream like completely different time zones than me. Two of them are in Great Britain, so it's usually different times. Most of them, we have PS4, PS3, PC, Xbox 360, and Xbox One. We're not a hefty streaming guild like others that have, like, you have to be a partner or you have to, like, do this or that. You just simply, if preferred, you just put it in your title or put it in the corner of your screen. OBS, it's really easy.
It is easy to do stuff with OBS.
Oh, yeah, and, you know, so. Yeah, I got a free XSplit account with my capture card, but I didn't like it. Because it wasn't free forever, you know, eventually I had to pay $20 a month for it. And Evolve, but I didn't see why I should bother trying Evolve since I really liked OBS. So.
Oh, for a minute I thought you were talking about the game.
Yeah.
The other game does look
yeah,
does
I'll
look good.
Join your guys'.
Yeah, I mean, it's still up and growing. It's just about, you know, working together. You share followers and promote each other versus streamers that are really, like, refuse to, like, mention other people and, you know, things like that. We're not like that with mine. It's partnered or unpartnered, friendly streamers working together, you know, with the same kind of, like, zero want to hack and cheat and legit play and stuff like that. I don't care how people put it on their stream, too. Like, if you look on mine down the road or on YouTube, it's just, like, lower right-hand corner, just as playing on Geekly Gaming Network, Weebleed Geek. But then, like, you know... We retweet and host people, and so you get like extra PR and let's go from there. My goal in the end would be rather to run that than to play.
Nice. I used to cheat at some games, but I stopped.
I mean, most of my cheating was offline games, like old PC games.
Well, like I said, offline, you're not going to get the stigma. Online, one cheat one time could come back to bite you in the ass later, so you got to be careful. If you ever want to be a professional league tournament player, if you want to play with me when I go to tournaments with GTA, Battlefield, Call of Duty, and have a chance to walk out of there with $1 million real cash and world titles, you can't have even one skeleton in your closet. If they find that skeleton in your closet, even like talking on my show about how you cheated once in the wrong way, that's still happening. And that's why I try to get people to be clean here, is because you could really, it's all being seen, it's all being heard, you know. I always send off my show to like whoever, whatever games we play, I send it off to the makers, so like Rockstar sees our GTA. I don't know if they watch them, but you know, it's like I don't want people to be surprised if shit hits the fan, and that's why I'm always so honest about it. You don't want to be like, oh, I used to hack GTA online the first month. You know, I received hacked cash. They can tell the difference.
I did too.
Yeah, you know, I'm cleaned now. That's not a big deal. But it's about those active duping blocks in Minecraft. Let's say you make one YouTube video or you're caught on one stream duping blocks. Well, there goes any, like, legitimate to be able to ever say you're legitimate at Minecraft. Once you get caught or admit duping blocks, every time you do something, people are going to accuse you. Like, oh my god, you were duping blocks, you're duping blocks. No, you dupe blocks. Whether it's true or not, even Drugs Bunny, he did the most honorable thing. He had a hacked GTA account, and he started a whole new account. Because it was because people were still giving him the stigma of you're cheating, even though he wasn't. You know, stigmas aren't something you get to choose. They just happen, and they stick to you, and they're stuck there. And that's what, you know. You don't want to try to build a YouTube streamer like empire and then the very foundation brick like your gaming last year brings it all tumbling down.